Welcome, 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 you guys. This is Beard Advice Live. My name is Dan. This is the mayor. And I'm going to invite you guys to hit that thumbs up as you come in now, live, or in the future. And if you guys want to share this out, I do believe we can help some people. Mayor, number one, how you doing? Number two, what is this show all about?
Well, I'm doing really well. Always love being here. This is like coming home. And this time it was cool to see some of the updates down here. It's amazing. Really nice, warm. I kept saying, like, just comforting. It's very nice. And, you know, I was good before, but things are going to change. Check out the new camera. Yeah, that is a little bit, I do like that.
Mm-hmm.
But this is Beard Advice Live. And in Beard Advice Live, we give advice on beards. Guys, send in typically to our email address, beardadvicelive@gmail.com. And they just kind of highlight what are their questions, what's their journey. They might go into their routine. It doesn't really matter. If you have a question, we're more than willing to answer it because it likely will not just help you, but someone else. So we ask usually that they send in a front-facing picture and a side picture so that we can get a good look at what's going on with the beard. And anybody from 18 to 88.
Yeah.
98 if you want. I don't know.
For sure. Anybody. That is one of the sources of pride of this show is the diversity. We have every beard shape, size, color you can imagine. We have every age ranging from the spectrum of being able to grow a beard. And even before, we have some of our students and former students that watch and get entertained, which is wild to think about that they would watch a beard show. But one of the most prideful moments of the stream is you guys helping. We say it every week, but it's true. I give advice. The mayor gives advice. Sometimes it's the same. Sometimes it's different. But then the third person in the room is you guys. You guys give that advice in the chat. We also do love that this is a supportive, that this is a positive place. We're genuine. We're going to tell you what we think will help your beard, and we're going to deliver it in a beautiful package. But it's not ever going to be negative. It's not ever going to be tearing down. It's going to be real advice in a real positive way. So if you guys are excited about that, again, hit that thumbs up. Shout out to Lance. He said, shared you guys out to Facebook. Thank you. The greatest way to help this stream, to help this community, to help this channel is by sharing this platform, sharing this live stream for as many people to see as possible. Pretty awesome. And we have a solid amount of entries today. Not a crazy amount, but not a low amount either. It should be just perfect. And we do have a segment about halfway through the show where we open it up to questions from you guys. Do you have questions about your beard, about trimming, something for the mayor, something for me, something for the chat? So if you have something that you've been wanting to ask, this is the show, and just give us a little bit of time. If it pops up, I'll probably star it and save it. But if you can save it till that halftime, I promise you guys, we will get to that. But I do know some of you have to leave, and so you ask the question, then you come watch back on replay. Totally fine. Totally fine. And outside of what we do on this show, we do have some traditions that we partake in every Wednesday. I had Sam made some like chicken and rice, and it was like a spicy curry type sauce, and I wanted a pop so bad, but I was so good, you guys, I did not have one, knowing that we have two traditions here, kind of gave one away. But Mayor, what are our traditions?
I couldn't wait for you to ask. I've been like craving. I wanted to get into all of our traditions. The first one, as Dan said, is we usually have a pop. This will be your second week of Code Red in a row. Hit them with the close-up. Yeah, we know Mountain Dew is not great for you, but this is kind of like our dessert. It keeps us up, keeps us going, keeps us energized, activated,
and dialed in.
Yeah.
I just enjoy it. I like the feel of it on my tongue. I love the flavor
of
it.
And sometimes you can just enjoy things.
Like, yes.
You know, you can do that.
Yes.
In life.
And it is, I will say, it is weird for me on this new health journey. I guess it's not that new. We're coming up on like 5-6 months now, and some real nice gains, if I say so for myself. Woo. But almost entirely my food intake now is purposeful. Everything I eat, like I never really understood the term empty calories. I do now. And I do feel guilty, but I also want to treat myself. I also want to step up. And I don't eat as much candy as I used to. I don't snack like I used to, mainly because when you eat enough protein, you're just ridiculously full all the time.
Yes. It's isn't that amazing what a difference that makes?
It's wild.
Well, just being just exercise itself and having the endorphins, you recognize how much I still am shocked by how much the food intake was pleasure seeking, just a positive, like then.
Or boredom.
Right.
Mine was boredom. As a teacher, it almost got drilled into me. I would grade papers. I had to be active while I was grading papers. Why? Because there's no fun in grading papers. You're not supposed to say that, but it's a horrible part of teaching. That is not enjoyable. So I would use like a huge, massive bag of M&Ms, and it just became a habit for me. Well, as a teacher, you're never full. You don't have adequate time to eat. So it's been a total shift. This is a treat. This is a dessert. I don't eat ice cream. I don't eat cake. I'm not a baked goods guy. I like this. And I will never have more than one a day. And I do take days off just to make sure I can prove it to myself. So other than this, Mayor, what else do we got?
We do like beef jerky. Today we got the Lynx, the Duke's hot and spicy. And we're also doing the green chili. What do you think what are you more into for tonight, do you think?
I'm going to literally try both and rock from there. The green's hollering at me. But I'm okay with some spiciness, too.
Did you get the spicy? Because I wrestled with the bag before the show, trying to get the green chilies open.
You got it. Yeah, you
barely,
got it. You
barely.
Got it. Yeah,
barely.
The bag fought back against the mayor, but he got it. And, guys, as we open up to, we give shout-outs at the end of the stream, but I want to give a shout-out at the beginning of the stream in case anybody leaves. 8 p.m. Eastern on Sunday nights, you guys. I personally want to invite you to watch this man's show on this channel. It's called Beyond Bearded. It has morphed this year into an interview show, and it's a beautiful mix of interviewees. People in education, we've had lawyers, we had a music artist, we've had older gentlemen, experienced gentlemen, we've had younger guys. It's a really, really cool place. The mayor is really honing in on his interview skills, and I think it's something that you guys will enjoy. So just consider checking it out, give it a chance every Sunday, 8 p.m. Eastern, live right here on Dancy Bearded YouTube channel.
I appreciate that. Guys, I have fun with it, and I think you will have a great time watching it. All the interviews are selected as relevant to some of our beard communities, the people we think might be interesting or might help you. This Sunday, we actually have Parker Barnett. He's coming on. He is he's a college baseball player.
Yeah, he's a college baseball player.
Not playing anymore. But he also happens to work for a really reputable financial group in our area.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not going to give us specific advice because he can't.
Correct.
He's going to tell us all about broad strokes, what are we doing as far as planning for our future? I'll acknowledge it. There may be something else to watch at that time, but maybe it's not going well and you need to start looking at your finances.
Yeah.
Jump on over to Beyond Bearded and I got you guys.
Or you're boycotting the NFL
right. And
you don't want to watch for whatever personal reasons. Parker's an amazing, amazing young dude. He's both of our tax guys. He's both of our financial guys. He was, and this is not in a claiming way, but he was mine first. And the only reason why I say that, I was so happy with him as a person and as someone delivering his service that I recommended him to the mayor. If I recommend something to my best friend in the world, you know that's a legitimate person, legitimate thing. So that's going to be a great show. I'm so excited to have Parker on. He's just a cool kid too, man. He really is. And kid, he's in his late 20s probably. So yeah, guys, we're going to hang out. How'd that Code Red hit?
So great.
Oh, yeah. And somebody asked, doesn't Mountain Dew have twice the caffeine normal soda? No, I don't think so. Somebody looked that up.
More.
Definitely more, but look up a...
I would guess 30 or 40%. I've seen that before in a science, like a magazine thing once.
Look up Mountain Dew versus Pepsi or Coke. Look up the caffeine. If it is twice, if it's 100% more, I would be shocked on caffeine. Because I don't think what is a unit of measurement of caffeine?
A microgram, maybe?
Okay, because I don't think they list it on any kind of beverage itself. So it's not like a stat you can look up on the bottle, but it's 45% more. Okay, so definitely not near twice as much. But
good look up, by the way.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. Okay, MGs for caffeine. Okay, all right. MGs, that makes sense. Yeah, I can see that for sure. But like I said, it's in moderation. Speaking of caffeine, I've never drank a coffee. I've never drank an energy drink. So I don't do anything. My pre-workout is caffeine free. So yes. Dan set the record straight. It's pop. That's true. That is true. It is pop, no doubt about it. For sure. Oh yeah, he is a cook. That would make sense. He knows that stuff. Hello, Scott. Thank you guys. And again, guys, hey, we got over 100 people in here, and we only have 51 likes. If you forgot, okay. If you're waiting for us to change your mind, okay. But just remember, it does help us out, and it is free for you guys to get involved. Speaking of free, Mr. Mayor, how do people get involved with this show, and how much does it cost?
The price, just this week only, actually, no, since we started, is free. So It doesn't cost you anything, and it really helps us out whenever you, if you ever have that doubt or that question, to send into our email, beardadvicelive@gmail.com. Front-facing photo, side photo, you'll see it over and over tonight. And so questions. It doesn't take probably more than 10, 15 minutes, and we'll get back to you and let you know you're going to be on the show.
Yep, absolutely. And Ken said it, not me. He said, hit that like button or he'll contact you about your vehicle's extended warranty. Woo, yeah, he'll find you too. Don't you worry. What's up, Brandon? How you doing, man? Got to that picture might be from that. We got to meet Brandon and his wife down in Dallas. Eric, thank you for the question. This will be an example, guys. I'm going to star this question, and we will answer it at halftime for the question segment. Dan, you ever work in a kitchen? Not directly. I was a bartender and a waiter slash server for many years in college, but I did not actually cook myself. I didn't clean or anything like that, but I spent a lot of time in the kitchen. You ever work at a restaurant?
They put me in front. I was the host of all the jobs. Can you? Does that surprise you?
No.
Welcome.
No.
Bill Nash restaurant.
Yeah. Yes. Look pretty. Got it. Nicholas, no. So this actually is a hat by, let me see if I can get this here, Handy Randy. This is one of my good friends. He's actually the contractor who has done work for both the mayor and I, and he has a big, beautiful beard, and he is renovating the studio floor. He did all that. He's doing Sam's shop, the rest of the basement. He's just a really good dude, and I wanted to support his business a little bit. He might stop in here. If you guys see like Bearded Builder in the chat, that's Randy. We'll give him a shout out. But he's amazing. If you guys are in the area and you want some work done, literally the best. And I've been through several, and I couldn't be any happier to recommend him. Shout out to Sam. What's up, Sam? Okay, here we go. Got it. All right, man, you ready to get this show rocking and rolling?
Let's go.
Beautiful. So, guys, if you are thinking about sending in next week or any future week, we love to have the write-up. The mayor's going to read that. And then we see pictures, and we do love updates. We are going to start off with an update from last week, and I'm pumped about this one. We're going to jump right into it. We gave this young man some advice. He took it, he used it, and he sent in just about an hour before the show started, and we made sure to get him in here. Take a look at this one from last week. This is Mike. I want to set the stage, guys. If you remember Mike, he had the really cool hair that was kind of shifted off to the side. He had a really nice base on his beard, but then had some long transparency that was coming down. I recommended to trim the transparency right here. The mayor followed up and said, hey, squint test, let's get rid of that, the spot that you can't see. And this is the result that we have for Mike's update here. And truly, truly,
oh.
This is what this show is all about. Mm-hmm. This is why we do this. The way we react to this in private is probably even more than in public. When I showed the mayor this update, and when I saw it for the first time, the mayor's like, woo, like that.
Yeah.
That's why we do this, guys. We want to help people out, and we do believe we have good advice to give from our perspective. And so this is exactly where it's at. What's up, Home Slice? So, yes. Okay. Here we go on this next one here. All right, Michael, reach out to me. I see your question there to discuss specific brands. We like to stay away from that as much as possible on Wednesday, but reach out to me individually, and I'd be happy to give you some feedback, man. And shout out to everybody in here, especially our moderators from the YouTube channel and the Facebook group. I saw Doug Sloan. I see Bill Savage out there. Shout out to you guys, man. All right, let's go ahead and see what we have for Mike. Oh, yeah, baby. Yep. I even want to bring this one in a little bit closer here. So this is the update, guys. Looking crispy, looking clean. This would be, when we talk about, I hate the term clean shaven, right? I don't understand that. All right, Michael, make it super simple, man. We don't discuss brands on Wednesday. That's it. If you want to ask about beard wash in general or beard trimming in general, that's what we go over. We try to stay away from talking about brands. Essentially, we don't want people to think that we're selling stuff. We don't want the pressure. We have the Monday night stream that features companies that talks about products. This is a break from talking about individual products. So hopefully that explanation will be good for you. But this is what we got here, guys. We had said essentially like, hey, let's go with the strength of the beard. Let's take off that transparency. Let's clean it up a little bit. And look at this, dude. Just absolutely crushed it. Mayor, thoughts, reactions, what you got?
So it's almost the same smile, but in the second one, it's the smile says, wow, That was a lot. That was a huge difference for not a lot of work. And he's like, huh? It was that easy? Kind of. That's why I'm reading that. And you're right. It was. It's a huge difference for not a lot of work.
Man, it just looks dense. It looks full. It looks purposeful. That's the biggest thing. The hair is killing it. Everything. And it looks like he went in and also cleaned up like the mustache and cleaned up the cheeks a little bit there. It's balanced. This is a look. This was someone that wanted advice, used it, applied it, and I couldn't be happier with the results. Couldn't be happier with the results, man. That looks fantastic. And this is another example, guys, of growing past your goal and then trimming back to it. There's always different methods to get to where you want to go, but this is one that is saying, hey, I want to get to this spot. He's going to grow past it, and then he trimmed right back to where it should be.
Love
Dude,
it.
Nice looks job. Amazing. Thank you for sending the update. If you guys do use the advice from the show, or even if you don't, if you take a different avenue, send back in. We want to see it. I love the feedback in the chat here, guys. So many people giving these really, really nice, comments as feedback. All right, that's tight. It does. It looks tight. It looks crispy. Night and day. Looks great, man. Amazing, Mike. Great style. That's awesome. Nice look. Nailed it. Sharp. Great job. Nailed it. Fantastic job. Looking good, Mike. Amazing. Crispy. Mike, I hope that you're in here. I hope that you take this in, but dude, it looks good. TJ has a good point here too. We do have this attachment to length, right? Yeah, There's a lot of guys that when we talk about goals, they say, hey, I want to get to a 12-inch beard. And I know for us, I know we've talked with Bill, our moderator from Facebook, many times. That like attachment to a number or to length can be the detriment of style.
Right.
And it does, man. TJ, you're right. It can be tough to trim off length. I get like a gut shot when I do it. I really do. And so to understand that, even when it's transparency, but the end result is worth it.
You know what your trim goal is?
What?
Happiness.
Ooh, yeah.
You gotta trim to your happiness.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. And here's Michael right here. Oh, he's a Pokemon fan too? Got that Altaria? Ooh, baby.
Well, not a shiny though.
Nope. It'll be gold. Nope. That is gold.
One of my favorite shinies.
That's a beautiful shiny.
That's how we got here.
Mm-hmm.
Pokemon.
Some people are like, who are these nerds? Yeah, we love Pokemon. He said, thank you so much. I thought the same. Thank you all. Man, thank you. That is really cool. Yeah. Who is this? Mike Jones. Who? Mike Jones. Who? All right, Vado, give me the phone number. Give me Mike Jones' phone number. If you know, you know. All right, here we go.
I don't know. Joseph
H. You don't know.
I am 38 and have a lot of gray. Should I diet? What product should I use? What's your advice in the mess? I'm looking for a good, full-looking beard. Thanks for all the help.
Ah, that code red was good. Was good here. All right, Joseph, let's go ahead and see here. Do you guys like retro Pokemon? All of them. Yeah, between like growing up with Pokemon, playing Pokemon Go, and then my kids being into new Pokemon, I think I cover the board and have pretty good knowledge on pretty much every Pokemon. All right, Joseph.
Wow.
Awesome. All right, let's pop back here real quick, guys. Let's pop back right here. 38, lots of gray. Should I diet? What product should I use? What's your advice in the mess? I'm looking for a good, full-looking beard. Whoo! Whoa! Joseph, this is called beard dysmorphia. You are seeing your beard in a very different way than the entire population is viewing your beard.
That's like dope. Like, that's...
Please read the comments.
What a show.
Wow.
Right out the gate.
Dude, number one, I don't think you have gray. I do not believe those are grays. I believe those are blonde. I see some like rustic in there, some red in there. That's just the color of your beard. Of your beard. It could be your beard too, but your beard.
Well, if you spill it.
True. And Daniel says, great color. Leave it alone. Dude, do not dye this beard. I forbid you. Do not dye this beard. There are only a few situations where I think dyeing a beard is in my eyes, acceptable. It's not the right word for it, but you guys know what I mean. And the main situation is when the structure of the beard becomes not seeable, not sound. And if you add color, it becomes more structured. This is not that case. This is a full, amazing beard. My goodness.
I'd say the chat is on full fan bearding right now. They're mm-hmm. fan, like this, you guys are going crazy for this.
And that's why I love this show. This man truly believes everything he said here. He said it was a mess. He said he was looking for a good, full looking beard. You have achieved that, sir. You have an epic level beard. Now, to answer your question here, what products should you use? Joseph, the two most important products, the essential products, would be beard wash and beard oil. Those are going to be very important for the health of your beard, for anybody's beard. Now, with your beard length, your beard texture, density, I really believe that you would benefit from in-shower conditioner and beard butter. Those are the only things that I believe you need. I don't think there's going to be any benefit for really anything else. Beard wash, beard oil, number one and two, one and 1A, followed by in-shower conditioner and beard butter. Joseph, if you need any recommendations, man, reach out to me. It looks like we have very similar textured beards. I would be happy to give you some recommendations based on your preferences. But again, we're not going over specifics here. So, dude, unbelievably amazing beard. Would not change a thing, and happy to give that advice on the products. Anything else there in that one?
Obviously, very thick, very big beard. As I look at Joseph's beard, first of all, thanks for this moment. I can thank you for that. That was really cool. Like, this is not who I thought we were going to see in the pictures. But also, Dan, I have a question for you. Someone's beard like that, best guess, how much oil, like how often would he go through a bottle of oil?
Great question. I would say, Joseph, you're going to be using between 2 and 3 droppers of oil, aka 40 to 60 drops. In that case, if you use a dropper a day, it'll last a month. So you're going to go through about 2 to 3 bottles of 1 ounce beard oils a month. Very similar to mine. Very, very similar to mine. And Jesse, I love this comment. He said, thank you for showing me that even a king bearded man like yourself has doubts. Yes, absolutely, man. People will tell me they have beard envy of mine. I literally have beard envy of many, many people that I see. So, wow, that is amazing. How much butter is that beard size going to take? So it's going to be a dollop. It'll be a little finger scoop, little dollop there. Hey, Aurora, good to hear from you guys. Thanks for coming in. Hey, Beard Octane, welcome. That's a 3-year beard. Yeah, I would guess that's between, with good growth rate, that's between, I would say, 2 and 3 years worth of growth. For sure. I have a feeling this man has great genetics and great beard health. Dialing in those products are gonna make a really nice difference as well. So, man, I so agree with Jesse here that even a beard like that can have some doubts and some, I don't want to say insecurities, but some wonderings and some goals.
Yeah, great point.
For sure. Yeah, exactly, Bill. I believe the exact unit of measurement for him, we talked about unit measurement for caffeine, I think his is precisely a dollop. Yeah. If you guys didn't get that, that's sarcasm. I got to clarify that. Sometimes people are like, Dan, I don't know how many dollops I need to use.
I Google searched it, and yeah, it's misleading.
It just gave me, like, actual butter. Mm-hmm. I'm like, ah, true.
Can't search it up. It's not real. That's what the kids say now.
Oh.
Oh, just search it up.
True. Well, that's the change in education. We don't open that basket, but it's not now about memorizing content. It's about how to get there, how to apply it, how to use it, how to properly ask it. Oh, man, there's crazy stuff. So, dude, great beard. Thank you for sending in. Thank you for trusting us. And, man, don't touch it.
This is Lance M. So my plan is to grow a full beard like I once had before in my mid-20s while I was battling cancer. I've just started using beard products. I put beard oil, beard balm in after showering, but I've noticed the sides seem to flare out within just a few hours. Just wondering what can be done to prevent that. Any advice is welcomed. More info on my beard. That's 3 months of growth. I've been using Honest Amish beard oil and balm so far and just got some samples in from Bad Donkey Beard Care.
There we go. All right, and guys, real quick too, since we're on here, man, Lance, I'm glad that you're doing well. Said he battled cancer in his 20s.
Glad you're here.
We're super open. Sam's posted stories and stuff. Sam had her ultrasound today. We should have results on Friday or Monday. If you're just coming in, she's had some really alarming thyroid issues and numbers, and we should be able to see an endo early next week, hopefully is the plan. She's doing good. She's in good spirits. She just goes to bed at about 7:30 each night because it just kind of wipes her out entirely. But everything is going well, and thank you to everyone that sent kind messages and checkups and stuff. So, yep, it's tough time for her for sure, but she's a fighter. We got this. Tons of support out there. And Lance, man, inspiration here that you're doing well. Inspiration to see a beard like this after you said battling cancer. So, dude, kudos to you, because oftentimes we associate cancer treatment with chemo, and chemo with losing hair and having not the ability to grow hair back in the same way. This is a wonderful, wonderful beard, dude. Man, the coloration on the front, the texture, the style, the cheek, the mustache. Fantastic beard. Fantastic beard. Thoughts, man?
Just when you say any kind of hardship, you always think maybe there's going to be, but it's just really, really shaped well, looks well. Love the coloration. I'm thinking like mine might white out just the same way, like in the front first. So I was kind of thinking about myself. I was in my own little beard daydream at the moment, but I think it has good balance. I don't see any need for a transparency trim. I think the mustache is well balanced. The sideburns look good.
Yeah.
Doing it real, like, the one thing we're going to say, with the hair, I think something that, we weren't asking, but, a style, maybe a little fade up or whatever you want to do with it. You could try some different things with the hair and make it pop a little bit more.
Yep. You know, read that.
Man, all that white was red in my 20s.
So the gray streak in his beard.
All that white was red in my 20s. Okay, all right.
Yeah, don't worry about that, man. It's beautiful. That's the natural progression that just changes with time. I've got streaks now, and, man, it looks wonderful.
Another question for you, Dan. I find that I notice the red in my beard this time of year more than I do in the summer. Now, would that be any kind of just lighting kind of thing, probably, where I'm looking at it, or?
It can be. Okay. So sun can, especially the UV rays, that can change the color of your hair. It's actually damage, right? When people say, oh, my hair gets lighter in the summer, your hair is being damaged. And it, over time, is irreparable damage. The reason why we can get away with it is we trim as it goes. Hair grows faster than on your head than on your beard. And so people that have, like, especially males that have shorter hair, gets light, they trim it off in a couple of months and you don't really realize the damage. That is likely the impact, but also the perspective of the brightness of the sun and stuff outside. So yeah, good question. Now Lance, to address one of your questions specifically here, he said that I put beard oil in and beard balm after showering, and then I have some flare out a few hours later. So Lance, you are at a length where that is going to happen. You are at what I call the second awkward phase. You are at the collarbone.
Between us.
You are at the, yeah, exactly between us. You're at the collarbone / the collar awkward phase. The mayor doesn't have to worry. Let me zoom in here. The mayor doesn't have to worry about his collars. This hoodie would drive me crazy because it would make my beard flare over here. This one actually lays really well, so.
Thank you. Might have to get the deets on that one.
I'll talk
to you about it.
All right. So when you have that issue where it starts to push on your collarbone, starts to push on your collar, that can cause that second awkward phase, and it almost always results in that flaring out. Now, people are saying heat in the chat. If I had to guess, I would guess that you are using heat.
Mm-hmm.
It does look like you are using heat here. If not, you have wonderfully straight, natural hair, and that's great. I would bet a lot that what you consider flaring out is only noticed by you. For someone like me that digests beards for a living visually, right? I would bet a lot that if you were like, hey man, this is what I mean by my beard flaring out, I would say, I don't know what you're talking about, dude. It looks fantastic. So I would keep dialing in your heat routine, keep playing around. Here's a wild toss out. A wild toss out. Consider ditching balm. Consider getting away from balm and consider going with oil only. Everyone always associates balm with hold, which is true. It absolutely can. But it also can hinder style, especially in a situation like this. What do I mean by that? If you have something that is flaring your beard out and you have balm, all that balm is going to do is lock in that flaring out stage. That's it. Right? If your beard is being pushed out here, the balm is saying, okay, let's stay right here. But if you don't have balm like me, right? If I had balm, my beard would stay like this. Well, I don't. It falls back down. So consider dialing it in without balm. And a lot of people would say, well, Dan, that's easy to say without a longer beard. Mayor, how often do you use balm?
Never.
Your beard is wonderfully dialed in. Like, that is a very stylish beard. When's the last time you wore balm?
I can't remember. Okay. Yeah.
Case closed. People always want to throw that at me and say, hey, man, but it's for shorter beards. You got to have it for a shorter beard to dial it in. Not if you know what you're doing. Not if you can dial in your heat. Not if you're using the proper oils. Not if you're not over-conditioning. If he was over-conditioning, if he was using heat in the wrong way, for sure, he's going to have some style issues. But that's all dialed in. That's all perfected, and it makes a huge difference.
And the thing that is to be to give you guys perspective is I never had a reason to stop practicing my beard. You know, when I can do a trim video or I have these techniques, it's because I've always been in the game on this. It's always benefited me. There was never a doubt in my head. I don't know if I would have a beard if it was just, you know, me kind of trying it. Probably not. Mm-hmm. I would have given up. So that's practice.
Yep.
A lot of things are.
Mitch, I love this point here. And he has a beard very, we featured him either last week or the week before. Very similar length beard than this one. Oil only gave me more volume. If flaring out is an issue because there's not enough volume, oil might give you more volume. And this is none of you guys, of course. But for the people that accuse me of things, of just doing things for money and selling products and stuff, guys, I'm telling you not to buy this product, not to use an additional product, right? So this would be on the outside looking in. This would be going against my own personal interests, but I don't believe in that. I don't think balm is necessary. Nope. Is it a tool? Is it something that can be used well? Yes, 100%. But it's not necessary.
You see, it sold a lot at the Barber Expo, though.
What's that?
The balm.
Oh, yeah?
It's a big product there, you know, because they're styling.
For sure.
You know?
For sure. So, yep. And a good heat routine eliminates the need for balm. Absolutely. Bearded Wolverine, 99% without balm. Absolutely. I think this is par for length. Also started using butter than balm. Absolutely, man. Leo says, I used to think balm was necessary. I listened to Dan saying oil only, and my beard is happier for that. And I agree with that to a next level as well. My beard is happier when it's breathing, when it's free, when it's not being constricted. There's a lot to think about there, guys. Just a lot to think about there.
Balm is a product often used by people who don't actually have to feel the beard.
Yeah.
Other people, you know what I mean? Because it is about how it makes my beard feel.
Vado is spot on here. Cubic, yep. Zirconia, same thing. Right. I don't like that feel either. I don't like the way it feels on my face. I don't like touching
it. If it drags on your coat.
Ooh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Guys, here's one thing with my beard. If you were to describe it as a finish, my beard would be a matte finish. When you wear balm, it is no longer a matte finish. It becomes shiny. It becomes greasy. That's just the nature of it. It's going to sit on the outside of your beard. It will never fully absorb in. That's just not what the product does. The molecules are not able to do that. So if you're thinking about the feel, if you're thinking about the greasiness, that is spot on. Absolutely spot on. So when would be a good time to start using balm? Or to stop would be any time. To start, I don't actually recommend it. I don't think that it's, I do believe it's a personal preference. I want to make sure I'm very clear there. But I don't believe that it's at all necessary or even beneficial in sometimes.
Yeah.
Balm is an extra conditioner for my beard. Absolutely, Mike. I would raise that though and say if you're doing it for the nourishment properties, butter will do anything balm will and will do it better. So this is, and I know some beard companies out there pulling out their hair. They're like, what are you saying, Dan? Hey. If you're trying to get those properties, beard butter can do the same thing. Same exact thing.
And you can't do it without oil.
Correct. I firmly believe that. And Leo says, saving money on beard products is a side benefit? 100%, like I said. Even going against my own career, livelihood. All right, I'm going to go with the oil. How about butter? Give it a shot. A lot of people do like oil and butter during the day. I don't. I don't think the mayor does.
No, butter's going to be in the evening.
Yep. For me. So give it a shot. It doesn't hurt to experiment.
It does. It makes it feel good in the morning.
Yep. Is it absolutely necessary to wash your beard before oiling? Not every day, no. I do. I think the mayor does because we work out daily. We get sweaty. But if you have a job, a lifestyle where you're inside, you're not sweaty, you're not around a lot of people, you can throw in rinse days and then put in oil. But you do want to put oil on a damp beard. I cringed at the thought. Same here, man. I avoid it at all costs. I truly do. Do you recommend butter after oil? Same thing. Personal preference. The mayor and I both are oil in the morning, butter before bed. That's it. Yep. Oil in the morning, butter before bed. I use butter too, but when wearing a beard mask all day, added balm conditions it a little bit better. It helps not dry it out. And that's a great situational awareness there. Mike, and I don't think he minds me sharing this, he works in the medical scene and he does wear a mask for that job. That's a great point. That's a great way to say, hey, butter's good, but balm works better for me here. Yes, Mike, I hear you, man. Thank you for sharing. That is awesome. Awesome. Okay. Good conversation. Butter in a dry beard? No. I believe any beard product should be applied to a damp beard. The thought of applying butter to a dry beard, it's like nails on a chalkboard for me. Why? Because you can't spread the product evenly. You're not locking in any extra moisture.
It's the kind of thing that would make you not like butter. If you try that the first time like that, I'm sure it happens all the time.
Dude. How many people have negative associations with beard products? Because one, they try the garbage silicone products from the store, or two, they're not using them properly. How many people in general have negative associations with beards because they don't know what they're doing? That keeps me up at night, and I'm not even kidding about that. The potential to make an impact on beards is massive because it's not something that is taught. It's not something that is intuitive. It's not intrinsic. You're not raised with that.
The heartbreaker is the potential for the impact that beer can have for someone.
Chain effect. Whew. So true. Hey, John, welcome, buddy. So true. And yeah, I think about that situation of, yeah, like you said, if somebody's using butter wrong, is that why they have a negative thought of it? If somebody's using a bad product, is that why they have a negative thought of it?
And I do it. Like, not anymore, but shampoos and face washes, lotions, things like that. There's just like even stuff, especially for your eye. You can't put it under your eye. You have to put it in the corner of your eye or else your eyes break out. Like, you have to read the directions as much as possible.
Yep. Wolverine, to the highest degree possible, yes. He said, do you find that some oils style your beard better than others? Yes. When I need my beard to look its best, I got about 3 oil companies that I can go to. And I can use them kind of interchangeably. And then it's pretty much everybody else. And there are some that make my beard feel amazing. And I know the health benefit is there, but it doesn't style as well. And those have great value too. But yes, to answer your question, straight up, there are some that make my beard style better than others. So yes. And Jenny Ray's Nate said, I recently tried butter on a dry beard and it was a no-go. Yeah, it's not. And that's why I love giving this advice. Because it's stuff that I've researched and I've experienced. And I give the advice wholeheartedly because I know people are going to try it and experience it for themselves. And that's the beautiful thing. And there's always outliers. There's always exceptions. But I love teaching the rule. Yep, I love teaching the rule. Temperature of water matter. So when you're applying products, having your beard around room temperature is best. If you're in the shower and you end with a cold rinse, by the time you're about to get that oil in, it's going to be room temperature. If you are getting water from the sink or a spray bottle, room temperature. That would be my best advice I could give to you.
If you're trying to wash your beard, you want warm.
Correct. Yep, 100%. 100%. Oil at night and oil in the morning, okay? Absolutely, Omar. Yep, as long as you're getting that beard damp. I only do oil at night if I take a nighttime shower as well. All right. Mayor, when's the last time you've taken a shower?
I don't remember.
Welcome to the show, guys. The mayor is a bath guy.
Woo!
Proudly. We break stereotypes
like
here.
Like 2 a day.
Yeah. Yeah.
A day, yo.
Yeah. Yeah. He's with that.
Baths on baths.
They call me double mash, triple dish. They call him double bath. That's what he's got.
When you get up 2 hours early to work out every single day, you can take a bath.
On this topic, Douglas says, if I wait 5 minutes after applying oil, my beard will be pretty dry. Is that why I've never noticed anything when using butter? Probably. Douglas, I would say 2 things could move the variables there for you. Number one, try to shorten that time frame. Go with 3 minutes. Number two, try to apply more oil. If your beard is dry after 5 minutes, something is off there. It could be you're not using the right company or companies for you and your beard. It could be that you didn't have the beard damp enough when you applied it. After 5 minutes,
maybe like way too much conditioner where it's not absorbing.
Could be. Yeah, but then it would be greasy.
Yep.
Probably the opposite.
Yep.
So there's something going on there. After 5 minutes, there are variables that we need to slide and adjust to make sure that it helps out. Yeah, to sure. Yeah, Devin, he's a bath dude. Straight up bath dude. Yep. John said, I tried a little butter on my dry beard last night in lieu of balm before going out. Gave me a little bit of control without being stiff. All right, John, that works, man. Thank you for the feedback. All right, Lance, thank you for sending in, dude. All right, here's Brian T. Is that a spicy one you did?
Yeah, I'm good, though.
You need a drink?
No, I'm good.
Okay, all right. They will understand.
I don't necessarily have a goal in mind, just wanting to have a purposeful, nice beard. My wife wants me to grow a long beard. What do you and the Bearded Brothers think? Should I go for a long beard, keep the length where it is now, just about 5.5 inches long? I can't decide on what to do with it. All right, now I'm better. I think that I like the length that it is now. I think I like the length it's at now. Sometimes I get frustrated with it because one side won't grow as good as the other. I know a lot of us have that issue. But just looking for general advice and opinions, give me your honest opinions. I can take it. By the way, pictures are just oil only, no butter or heat.
Okay, all right. And I love this, guys, as an add-on when we're talking about using products the wrong way. Jason G says, a long time ago, I was using products wrong, so I stopped using them until I met Dan at the meetup. Now I use the products correctly. That's so dang cool. I love doing meetups, and I love going to places because I get to meet people like Jason who... I don't think Jason super followed the channel at all before the meetup and maybe was a little bit apprehensive, right? I get it. This internet YouTube guy, who does he think he is kind of thing. And I was able to talk to him and his buddies. And I know a lot of them have started watching videos. Jason is unbelievably supportive in the live streams and the videos. And man, I appreciate him. We even get to talk personally often too. So that's so absolutely cool to hear, man. Jason, seriously, thank you for saying that. And like, take a step back. Think about this community that we're in. Where we talk about breaking stereotypes, right? It's not a thing for men to kind of be vulnerable, to kind of share thoughts and feelings. And this dude is coming out on his own type and saying, hey, I used to do this wrong, met somebody, learned, now I do it the right way. That's freaking cool.
Yeah.
Like, that is cool, man. I love everything about this stuff. All right, Brian, let's go ahead and take a look at the beard and get some thoughts here. Boom! What up, Brian? Oh, I know Brian.
Yeah.
Awesome, dude. So, Mayor, break it down. What's our main... Where he's at here, he said,
just looking for general advice and opinions. He says he's...
Should he go long?
Debating his length and where he's at with that.
Okay, all right. Guys in the chat, girls in the chat, should he go longer? Should he maintain? Should he go shorter? And just general advice. You want us to kick
sure.
this one off?
You know, it's going to be... The way you have it trimmed is very similar to mine. And so going longer is going to be, I think, quite... you're gonna have to let the sides catch up with the rest of it. So you've got some time ahead of you. On that note, too, I think it looks really good the length it is. In my opinion, you have a very thick, dense fur, like reddish beard, is very, very cool, and that does like look powerful in a shorter beard because it just has there's something to it for me. So I like the way it looks as it is. I think. Not much advice at all, you know. You have like your underneath the bottom lip, you kind of have that same little whoop that I have. Work on heat with that, but and let it get longer. The longer it gets, the more it'll lay down.
For sure. SDZ agrees with you. He says perfect beard for his face shape, kind of maintain it here. Brian, you have the wide open canvas. This is another proud member, card carrying of the Bald and Bearded Club. For me, actually. This happens oftentimes. Leo takes the words for me. Let it go longer. If it reaches a point you don't like, keep it at that length, but don't plan on now for a goal. Here's my advice, man. We know you can rock this. We know this looks good. But in your head, you are asking, should I go longer? If you don't go for it now, when are you? When are you going to go for it? If you don't go for it now, in 10 years, are you going to ask, man, what if I would have did that back in my whatever 30s, back in my whatever age you're at? I think you have to go for it. Number one, stop trimming that mustache. Leave that alone right now. If you do need to trim the mustache, stop taking buzzers and clipping the whole thing off here. Just go along the lip line. If it's a kissing thing, if it's an eating thing, I promise you we can achieve what you're looking for by trimming along the bottom the bottom line of that upper lip. I am not a fan of the buzzed mustache. We can go shorter. We can go with a little bit tidier. Stop buzzing the mustache. Don't do that one. And then for right now, just let it go. Also, by the way, Brian, your fade from the sideburns into the bald head, immaculate, perfect. I've been giving advice on that line a lot lately, and I really love where yours is at. Yours could, I'm gonna make a video on this, and yours could be included on the textbook of what to do there.
Ooh, textbook.
Oh, I love this quote by Greg. If you don't do it this year, you'll be 1 year older when you do. So true. So true, man. So, yep.
At least 1 year older.
Yep. And as Mike L said right there, if you don't like it, you can always come back to it. That is exactly where I'm at. Don't set a hard goal. Just grow it out. Enjoy the journey. The second you don't enjoy it, then you cut back and you adjust. As the mayor said, you have all the genetics to do whatever you want. It's a great, great base there. Awesome, man. And Brian's always super involved on the channel, and I appreciate that a lot. Yep. And Dan says, go longer. It'll more likely adjust itself. Yep, absolutely, man. I agree. Robert says, go longer. So you got options, dude. Keep us posted on whatever you do. You can pull off anything. Truly. Beautiful. Just have fun. Absolutely.
All right, Mrs. Buffalo Todd. Enclosed are a couple photos of my beard. Walter's the beard.
I think so.
Due to side effects of chemo, I can't grow out the mustache and block my mouth. My goal is to have a Santa beard. The smiles I get from kids brings me joy. My question is, do I trim it now or wait until after No Shave November when it's Santa season? Thanks for your time.
Okay. All right. So let's get this together. He wants a Santa beard, but he says, do I trim it now or do I do it after No Shave November when it's Santa season?
So before we click, we're thinking, you and I are thinking, we're thinking, what is that? We are like 10 months out from Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
So we have to kind of shape that in our head. So I kind of get an idea of where he's at. Is he going to need to adjust something major in the meantime or not at all?
Yeah, let's see here. All right, Buffalo Todd. Oh, man. Great beard. Once again, not what we expect, not what we think here. Okay. Why is the trim being asked about? I can't grow out the mustache and block my mouth. Okay.
Right, trim. I think maybe he's using the term trim in terms of like start styling it that way, kind of like shaping it.
Maybe.
You know, all right. That's my guess.
Respectfully.
Because we wouldn't have to take anything.
Yeah, respectfully, Buffalo Todd, and I talk with him all the time. We've been buddies for a long time now. I'm going to take a path away from that, and we're just going to give you general advice with the framework of you want a Santa beard because it brings joy to you, and I promise you it brings joy to those kids as well.
Yeah.
So first thing I want to address is the mustache. She says, I can't grow it out because I don't want it over the lip. A lot of people in the chat are going to know exactly what I'm going to say here. They call you Buffalo, but I want you to envision the lazy walrus. Buffalo Todd, we need to get some heat from a heated brush and start brushing that mustache off to the side. Off to the side. Yep, and hey, we do have a resident Santa here. Literally, this is Ross. He is an amazing Santa. He said, let it grow out more and shape it at Christmas time. Ho, ho, ho. All right, I agree. You don't touch this beard before Christmas time at all. And then, if anything, during Christmas time, you come in and you kind of dial it in and shape it up. For now, I'm just going to give you that advice on the mustache. Heat off to the side. Get that bad boy out of your mouth, but keep it nice and full.
Yeah.
Beyond that, Mayor, you have anything on the beard, on anything?
Heat off to the side. Well, you know, maybe a blowout or what we're doing underneath could be just practice that technique as well. When it does come time, if you really want to go for the full Santa, you're going to balance that kind of thing out, but really your suggestions are good.
Cool. What do you think about hair? Anything that you would suggest on the transition or no?
It depends on what it's, you know, he's got kind of the funky look. You know, it's kind of cool. Like the so if you like that, cool, but if you also, you'd also look great with a fade.
Yeah. Even just Buffalo Todd in super simple terms, just going shorter. Think about a line like right here. Just going shorter on this portion of the head hair. Just something to consider. Yep. It looks great, man. Your beard is definitely Santa territory, and it's definitely going to make a lot of kids smile. All right. So this is halftime, guys. This is where we share out some questions that you guys have. I have two starred already. The first one that we talked about earlier is from Eric Larson. He says, fellas, what are your opinions on minoxidil for beard growth? And there's Buffalo Todd in the chat. Thank you, sir. Super simple, Eric. There are three possibilities when it comes to minoxidil. Number one, and if you guys don't know what minoxidil is the active ingredient in Rogaine. Rogaine is the brand, minoxidil is the ingredient. It's kind of like Kleenex and tissue. where everyone just associates Kleenex as being that thing you blow your nose with, but that's a tissue and the brand is Kleenex. Same thing here. So essentially this is Rogaine, but it's the active ingredient. And super interesting, Rogaine was initially used for medicine for your heart, and then somebody put it on their hair and started to realize it could grow hair. Mm. Three outcomes, Eric, that could happen. One, you get good beard growth where there was not. That is proven. It can absolutely happen. Two, you have no results. You're right back where you were. Three, there are some negative effects that can happen with your beard and your health. People have reported even things like heart palpitations. Do we recommend minoxidil? We don't go into that. That is a drug. That is something that is outside of what we recommend. Just really do your research. There's massive amount of beard channels on YouTube. Lots of beard product reviews, lots of tips and tricks like I do. The amount of minoxidil videos is 10 times as many. My biggest video in channel history is a minoxidil video. So check that one out, go into it, but we can't get into too many details because there are risks involved, right? That's the nice thing with beard oil. Other than allergies, there's no real risk. So good question. Have you ever tried emu oil on your beard? I have tried it by itself, actual just straight up emu oil, and then I've tried it in many different blends and also ostrich oil. Hacker, one thing to know about those bird oils, as we call them, it's an extreme anti-inflammatory ingredient. So the end result usually is a much softer beard. For me, it is too soft to style. So I only wear it at night if it's the first ingredient on the list.
Thank you, Doug.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Doug. All right. What about you, Mayor?
Yeah, definitely as a blend in a couple different companies' oils. And I find it to be very softening, but a very nice part of a rotation of oils.
Yeah, I agree for sure, for sure. All right, is it bad game face moisturizer on your bed? Yeah, if it's intended for your face, especially something like a moisturizer, keep that away from the facial hair. It's totally fine. I use oil, but there are facial moisturizers out there to do it on the rest of your face, but you don't want that on your beard.
Yeah, I talk about this all the time. I feel like you need to. The skin under the beard is taken care of by your oil routine, right?
Yeah.
It's not there. Your face, yeah, definitely. You should be doing regular SPF to protect from the sun and a moisturizer.
For sure. Hey, Dana Merritt, what are your beard weaknesses? I don't recall you guys mentioning it. All right, I'll hit mine and then I'll come back to you. For me, Carlos, it's very simple. It's the forking of my beard at about 12 inches. I'll take this away and bring it back here. When I get beyond this, my beard starts to do this. And I absolutely hate it. It is the demise of my beard. So I do things like this. I do things like this. I style it, cover it up. I get away with it pretty well. But that's my number one. Everything else, my mustache, star. My density, my thickness, that side beard. Come on now, forget about it. That's all good. I'll be honest there. But it's definitely the French fork at about 12 inches.
Right now with the new beard coming in, for whatever reason, I have this see-through. It's a little bit lighter this time. And I feel like there's this spot that I can always see, and I had to get a pimple there once, and everybody was looking at it. I swear they were, but they really weren't. But so I have that little transparency spot there. This never just plays ball. My neckline, it's thick, but it's like teenagers, right? It's gonna go the opposite direction just because it can, just to see what you're gonna do to test you, because you don't even understand it or nothing. So those are my big spots, really.
So your beard is oppositional defiant sometimes?
Sometimes.
Okay.
When it doesn't get enough sleep, really. It gets a little hangy.
Dude, when you have kids and you realize that every single action is guided by food and sleep, it changes everything.
Yep.
It changes everything. Truly. I can tell you what's going on with my kids because of their food and because of their sleep. So that's wild. All right. Grouse. Dan, have you ever had a phase where it seemed like your beard stopped growing? I'm at 10 inches now. Me too. Maybe a little bit more, but right there. And I can't see any growth for 2 months now. No, that is not true. You might not see it, but I promise you, Grouse, that your beard is growing. Doug will pull up, because he's the man, a video. If you search on YouTube, beard stopped growing. Mine will be in the first three videos. This is what we call the law of proportionality, Grouse. Your beard is growing. But the longer and bigger it gets, the less you notice it. For example, in 2 months, I would bet your beard has grown an inch, even though you didn't realize it. Why? Because an inch compared to 10 inches is a very small amount. It's not a huge difference, right? 10% difference. If your beard is the length of the mayor's and we add an inch onto his beard, that's a massive difference. And you're like, oh my God, my beard grew an inch. Wow, that's crazy. At my length, I couldn't even tell. Right now, I could not tell you if my beard was 10 or 11 inches. No concept. But we could really tell if the mayor's beard was at 3 or 4 inches. So it's just simply you not noticing it. Hey, what's up, Randy? Randy, I gave you a shout out earlier. My man. So hopefully that helps you out, Grouse. I promise you, your beard is still growing. The term terminal length will get thrown out there. You're not there. Trust me. Worst case scenario, you're at a beard plateau where it has temporarily stopped. That usually has to do with something internally or maybe the products that you're using. But I don't think that those are the case. Yep, I don't think that those are the case. Can I add an unscented oil? We'll just use that in general to other beard brands to increase overall effects. Absolutely, man. Nothing wrong with mixing oils. Totally fine. Especially unscented ones there. Ryan, go crazy, man. Have some fun with that. There's very, very, very little risk or downside to mixing oils.
Just don't use too much because you're blending. Mm-hmm. You know, like accidentally increase how much oil you have.
Yep. Hey, Dan, had a question about the claw-like clips to hold the beard in place for bed. Will this cause problems over time? Probably not. I think you're talking about those butterfly clips that women use. Nope. If you're going to clip your beard, I actually recommend those. Those are usually a pretty easy way to clasp the beard, but not have really any damage to it. Now, if you clasp it and you're rolling around in bed and you're pulling and tugging at it, then you could have some issues. But other than that, you're totally fine. TJ says, not looking for specific recommendations, but how many different brands you use for washes and conditioners? When I'm not reviewing, I have 3 brands that I rotate through for washes and conditioners almost entirely. It's been more, it's been less, but I got about 3 that I would say. Do we need to account for the fact that facial wash is getting a beard? Great question, Sterling. No. Here's the key thing. As long as your beard is saturated with water, meaning your beard is completely wet, and you apply that facial, whatever it is, face wash, facial moisturizer, any kind of facial product, and you're not massaging it into your beard, all it's going to do is run right off. When that beard is full of water, it's got a barrier to it. I guess here's a fun fact. The electric charge of water is the opposite of your beard. And so it sits on top of your beard until it evaporates or it absorbs in. And if you're in the shower, if you're in the sink, all that facial moisturizer is going to do is just literally run right off your beard. Have no worries. Here's another example. I washed my beard today. I did not use conditioner. I washed my beard first, and then I did body wash. Had a little dollop of the body wash land right on it. Rinsed it out. Don't have to worry about it. Why? Because my beard already had that barrier.
The mayor, me, I do shampoo, face wash, and beard wash all at the same time. Benefit of the bath, you dunk your head underneath the water, get it all out at the same time.
And then you got to sit in it for the rest of the bath.
Well, then you're draining. Spray off. I have a sprayer. I don't use it.
I've learned when I feel good and I'm happy, oh, man. So true, dude. So, so true. I got to take a picture. There's something there, Ray. There's something there. When you feel good, you look good. When you look good, you feel good. Man, I actually listened to a very interesting podcast on this exact topic and how it resonates with women and men differently. And there are some actual differences there in how negative feelings manifest themselves and how you look at it. Men are biologically much better off and easier on ourselves as compared to women. They're
toxic.
Yeah, their negative thoughts are directly related to how they view themselves. And that's not just like observation stuff. It's proven. If you guys are curious, I can send you that podcast. It was really, really good and made so much sense. All of us, I grew up with 2 sisters. I had a mom, Sam, of course. All of us can usually kind of be like, oh, wow. And so much of that mood is attributed to how they look and how they feel about themselves. And it's so vice versa. It's crazy, crazy, crazy. When I heard that, I was like, wow, that made a lot of sense. And I bet some of you listen to that same podcast. It's, spoiler alert, it's the largest podcast in the world. I'm with a recent guest, too.
Not mine.
Yeah. Are beard washes bad to use on full face? Totally fine. Might not be as effective, but totally fine.
Yeah, it's soap.
Yep.
You know?
Yep. Well, it's not soap, well, but it's a wash, similar.
Something that will remove oil.
Yeah. Yep.
I give you a great, like, you.
And that is important, though, because soap is the saponification process, and it has a totally different. Has a totally different ingredient process. Has a totally different pH.
Gotcha.
You can use it, but it's not likely going to be optimal. Is it possible to use too much product, Roger? Yes. Most people starting out use too much product. Which products can you use too much of? All of them. Absolutely all of them. What are the consequences? Depends on the product. Too much beard oil? You're going to clog your pores. You're likely going to get beard acne, and you're likely going to have slower growth. Too much conditioner? All of those same problems. What else did you experience with too much conditioner?
I never really noticed the difference in oils. You know, you're because of the hair gets coated with conditioner, I didn't get the benefit of some of the oils. So my beard feels better now that just the skin's able to get to it. Everything was coated in that conditioner, I think.
Yeah. Too much butter, buildup, clogging the pores. Your beard's not going to style as well. Same thing for balm. Yes, to the maximum level, you can use too much products. I'm actually going to take a picture of that, too. I've done something similar in the past, but
this might be a show idea, like an idea show.
For sure. You know, sometimes it just pops like that. How would you recommend down your carving your beard into? So that's going to be more along the lines of a scuba trim. Grooming and reviews. I'll give a shout out to a channel because he gave us one as well. Not because that's why, but he did give us one. Maddie Conrad actually just 2 days ago posted a video on how to trim into a Kronos, God of War beard. Check out that video, Maddie Conrad. We are buddies. We talk. We don't agree on everything beard related, and that's okay. You should be able to hear multiple opinions out there. I'm okay with people feeling different ways. Check that one out. Scuba, aka Beard Tube. He'll have better trim tutorials on that than I would. Okay. Dan, are you going to continue to grow your beard longer? So, Caleb, my goal is to enjoy my beard along the journey. If my beard continues to grow full, dense, and big, hey, thank you, Tyler. Full, dense, and big, I'm going to keep growing. If it starts to become transparent and starts to French fork, I'm going to stop and I trim it. And for me, I usually get to be about this length and then I take some off. So no plans. I'm just enjoying the journey. Do Babyliss trimmers have attachments?
Most trimmers come with a guard.
The guards? Side. Yes, they
at
are.
At that
like,
level, I'm sure they do.
Yeah, they're like king of the industry. That was one of my only big gripes against Brio is their guards are horrible. Yeah. The way they clip in and they're not secure and stuff.
Have you ever had one not on?
Yes.
And that's bad.
I've had it where one's been like, I had one side locked and then the other one wasn't, so it cut at a wrong angle.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah, their attachments are horrible on the Brio. Great trimmer, horrible attachments. Babyliss ones are really nice. They have normal ones, and then they have, like, reinforced ones. I have both, and they're wonderful. Do you recommend coconut oil for a thick, curly Caucasian beard? No. If it's a fractionated coconut oil, meaning they remove the thick stuff. You know how coconut oil is like a semi-solid at room temperature? What fractionated coconut oil is they remove what are called the long-chain fatty acids, and then it becomes a liquid. I don't recommend normal coconut oil because it has a high comedogenic scale rating, which means it's more likely to clog your pores than not. So no, there's just so many better options out there. If you're like, I want to do it simple, I want to be on a budget, you can reach out to me. I can give you some budget options that you can pick up at Walmart that are going to be likely even cheaper than a lot of the coconut oils out there. But no, I don't recommend that. All right. Yeah, man. Of course, Randy. And I didn't even know that he was coming in. So that's awesome. Very, very cool. Should you condition after a stripping wash?
Absolutely.
For sure, man. For sure. But when measuring a beard, hey, man, we love this question. So this is competition rules for measurement. You measure your beard from the bottom of your bottom lip down to the length of your beard. And hey, I'm going to snap a picture of this too. Why? Because it gets asked every single week in a great way. Thank you for asking, by the way.
That's very, yeah.
Awesome, man. keep these questions coming, guys. This is what this is all about right here. I know not to use shampoo on my beard hair, but is it okay to use beard wash on my head hair? Yeah, for sure. I today used a solid beard wash bar on my beard and my head hair. I love those days because it's quicker. It's easier.
I will tell you, like, the conditioner for your beard is a little bit thicker. Like, it really conditions. So that one you can overdo easily on your head hair. So be mindful.
And it can leave your head hair feeling, like, greasy.
It just won't style. It just wouldn't play ball.
The mayor would know on that one.
I've done that too.
Have you ever reviewed the beard trimmer by Manscaped? No. I know they just came out with it. I likely won't unless they reach out to me, and then I'm going to do an honest review on it. So we'll see, but nothing planned right now. How do you stay hydrated when you don't feel thirsty? Man, so if anybody can help out Andy here, drop in the chat. For me, it's just a relentless ritual in my mind. I'm not during the show, but even during the show too. I'm just drinking water all day consistently. It's just ingrained in me. Not because I'm thirsty, but because I know how beneficial it is. It's just become part of my routine.
Yeah, I do battle with that sometimes too. So I, you know, as a teacher, you talk a lot. So sometimes you just need a drink anyways. So that's a big deal. But lately it's been interesting. I don't know what it is, but I've really caught myself heading into like a dehydration phase. My beard will tell me, like, it just, it feels limp. It feels like a plant that's wilted, you know,
my beard and my calf muscles.
It's like a warning sign that I haven't been drinking my water, and it's always accurate.
Yeah. It's so true. So true. Devin said, I recently bought some silk pillowcases per Dan's video, and I've noticed a difference. My beard and head hair are less contorted in the morning. Absolutely, man. It's scientifically proven. This is not something that was out of thin air. Anytime I do like detailed videos like that, you guys know I'm going to get criticism. I'm going to get comments. Somebody told me, this is BS, man. You're making this complicated. Guys, ask any woman in your life. Most of them are going to tell you that silk is better for your hair and for your skin. Our beard is no exception. Now, is that for everybody? Should everyone go buy silk? No, of course not. But if you're someone that wants your beard to be better in the morning, you want your beard to be healthier, you want your skin to be better, that is a provable fact that it is better for your skin and your hair. And I will never go back, ever. Number one, I like the feel of silk more than I do cotton. I don't like cotton at all. I don't even like it that much in my shirts. Like 100% cotton shirts, I'm not usually a fan of. There's a couple, but not usually a fan.
Not 100 on 100%.
Yeah. I don't know what that means, but
100% cotton. You're like, you're not. Oh, yeah. Like, you know, you hit 100 on something. Oh, you're like, that's
okay, 100. Okay, okay. Got that kid talk. Not 100 on 100%. I got you. So, Devin, yeah, it's factual, man. It really is. I'm glad you're noticing the benefits. I wouldn't talk about it if I didn't experience it, if I didn't truly believe in it. And I love going in on those minute details. That's my style. That's what I do. I'm not going to be up here making the funniest shorts on YouTube. I'm sorry, guys, if you're looking for that. That's not me. The mayor and I aren't going to be doing somersaults together. So it's just not our style. We're going to talk about silk pillowcases. Oh, man. And welcome everybody in here. I have a question about beard brand products. Okay, beard softener. So yeah, we try not to discuss specifics, but asking here, their beard softener is what they consider a conditioner. I love beard brand, but I don't really like that product, especially the more and more I've used it over the years. So no. The leave-in conditioner can be part of the rotation when using conditioners. Omar. Yes. Personal preference, beard type really matters here.
Yeah.
I used to use it, leave-in conditioner, maybe once a month or so. I have completely cut it out. I don't have any benefit to myself with it. Now, with that said, there are beard types that do benefit from it, especially beards like an African-American beard that is curly, that is coarse, that has a different structure to it. That is very common to use that. So it depends on your beard. I recommend if you are going to use it as a nighttime leave-in. But again, there's wiggle room there. I'm probably not the best person to ask on that one. If you want to check out my video on my channel with JMo704, he talks about it with his experiences, which are very different than mine. Okay. Anamia, reach out to me. Send me a message. I'd be happy to go over brands and talk about preferences in the different ones for you. Have you ever used butter for a midday restyle? I used to, Joe. A couple years ago, that was a massive part of my day, especially with teaching. I'd get home and I'd get my beard damp and I'd apply some butter. I haven't done that in several years. What about you?
No. I don't like the potential to be sweating with it in my beard.
Yep. Unfractionated coconut oil will freeze in the winter. So true. Any of those oils that are somewhat like solid or semi-solid at room temperature, they will become solid in the winter much quicker. Babassu oil is a good example of that. Another one, what's the other one I was thinking of? Shaolin oil. Those are both going to freeze in the winter if it's a prominent or if it's by itself. Thoughts on the Laffian Bro Dryer? Let me see. I don't even know. Remember how to spell this, Mayor.
L-A-F-I-E-N.
I have to look this up because Sam... Oh, okay. So this looks like... Oh, this is the... This looks very similar to the Dyson blow dryer.
Does it?
Yeah. I have a feeling, Mike, that... And I can show you guys. I have a feeling that this is a really good tool. Sam just got... And I'm going to have to try it and make a video on it. Sam got the... It's like the Shark. It's like a knockoff of Dyson. Yeah, so Sam, something like this. Sam just got this one. So this, that blow dryer you see right there, Sam just got that. It looks very similar to what you were saying, and she loves it. She will never go back again. It was not cheap, but she said it was 100% worth it. So,
good question, Mike. What does she like about it?
It has a ton of attachments. Has the ability to swivel and become like a straight one that you can use like to curl, to blow. She just really likes it. It's just a good quality one. But that one, Mike, it looks very similar to the Dyson, which is $400. but my sister has it and says it's amazing. How long is the mayor's beard? I have a 4.5-inch beard, round bottom. Thinking about trimming 1 inch because of the professional customer. Thoughts? All right, Bear, how long do you think
like,
your beard is?
If we're going bottom lip, it's like, what, 2 inches, 2.5?
If you're okay with this, take like the bottom portion of your beard and kind of pull it out. Like, is it able? Okay. So if you're pinching it to your chin, you got about a knuckle? Like if you're going into your chin here?
Pinching it to my chin, I don't know.
Like this, like straight on like this. Yeah. About how long is it? It's about a knuckle.
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, he's got maybe a half inch off the chin. 3/4 inch off
the
chin.
It's just the pinch?
Like right where your chin is. Get a hair there.
Okay.
Gotcha. Wherever an individual hair is.
Okay, on my chin.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, so it's not quite an inch yet. So, yeah, his is probably about 3/4 inch off the chin. Mm. He's saying he's at about 4.5-inch beard, round bottom. Think about trimming an inch. You'd have to send in, Justin.
Yeah,
send in, man. It's hard to go from the avatar there. Yeah. He said going down... Yeah, that's tough. A house without rulers?
No rulers at the studio table here.
This is house? No, Leo. But studio? Yes. does Dan not grow his beard? Yep, 100%. Well, it starts to become transparent. It starts to break at that point. So, yeah. Yep, 100%. Your beard is looking tight.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Have you guys ever tried Truff? Yeah, hate it. Absolutely. I had somebody send it to me, and I felt so bad because I was disgusted by it. I've tried all three flavors of the Truff. Didn't like it. You tried it?
Yeah.
What?
You gave it to me, man.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Like, I tried it, too.
And yeah, it was, I told him I
liked
it with
pretzels. Or I liked it with certain things, but so rich. Like, I just was not super my thing either.
Yeah. Josh says, hey, Dan, are you going to review the Live Bearded Head Hair Shampoo and Conditioner? They sent it to me, but I don't have any plans to. I'm not thrilled by the ingredient list. I love the company. They're an affiliate of mine. I would probably make money if I did a video on that, but I'm not going to. There's no plans for that. Even though I love the company, love their oil, love their conditioner, but no. At what point are you truly over combing your beard? Never, ever, ever, Sterling.
That's damaging it.
The longer, I think he's saying, at what point are you truly, okay. You're right. Let me rephrase. I read that as, at what point, like, is there a length when you're just over combing your beard? You don't need to. Rewind. Mayor, can you over comb your beard?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. If you're talking about, like, damaging it, Sterling, you want to avoid combing your beard when it's dry at all cost. If you do, like I did right before this show, you just want to be very gentle. You want to be very light. That's the key thing. If you have a good tool and you're gentle and you're light, you're not getting tangles, you're not getting snags, you'll be okay. But a lot of guys don't do that. A lot of guys like to go quick. A lot of guys like to power through things. That's when the damage really starts to happen. So, yeah, good question. Okay. Have you ever had a time when you weren't motivated to... No, I know this is unique. We hear this from people all the time, but no, I have never, ever, ever had the moment where I didn't want to take care of my beard, where I wanted to trim my beard off or shave my beard. I've literally never experienced that. I love taking care of my beard. It genuinely is a highlight of my day. I love that process. It's like therapy for me. It's my time. I enjoy the beard products I wear. I like my beard looking good. It's a sense of pride for me. So no, I have never been there, but I know people have. What about you?
You know, honestly, having the beard was the first thing I consistently needed to do every day. And I have built a lot of things around that first, getting used to having that habit has created a lot of positive habits.
Yeah. It's there's a book and a speech called Make Your Bet, and that's kind of the thing. You start the day with that. It's powerful. Rob says, thanks for answering my question today. Yeah, absolutely, man. And thank you guys for dropping questions on this stream, but also know you're welcome to reach out to me anytime. I respond and answer every single one of those, and I do it with pride. I really, really love it. George, reach out to me, man. I'd be happy to tell you some good options that are at Walmart, but reach out to me. Tyler, yeah, we got to do a B-Dubs meetup soon. It's, yeah, crazy times. Chevy says, I'm deaf. Hopefully, maybe you can answer my question type here. Beard must have conditioner or nah? All right, Chevy, I'm going to answer out loud, and then I'm going to type you a comment as well. Not needed. Conditioner is not needed for the health of the beard. It can be amazing to detangle, to soften. I love it. I use it sparingly, 3 to 4 times a week, mainly 3 times. But it's not needed. No, absolutely not. Okay, keep these ones going. I know a guy who has a massive beard. And he says he just uses pure vitamin E. It's the best thing to use. What's your opinion? There are genetic freaks out there, Lance. There are guys who will never use anything on their beard. There will be guys who never touch their beard, and they're going to have a massive beard. Now, I noticed you didn't say a massively immaculate beard, a massively purposeful beard, a massively dialed in beard. And maybe he does, but that's rare and few and far between. Normally, when a beard gets to massive levels, you can tell that they're only using vitamin E. I don't even usually like vitamin E as a prominent ingredient high up on the list. I've only had one oil that I thought was good that had vitamin E higher up on the list. So for me, no. But there are exceptions to every rule. Yep. Yeah, it's the shark blow dryer. It was not cheap. Sam used her Etsy money and was like, I want to invest in this. I'm like, all right, go ahead. Okay, so John bought it. Works great. Watched a bunch of reviews and people say it's better than Dyson. Cool. First time I've heard of that brand, so good to know. Is it okay to use a blow dryer and a heated brush? Yeah, we both use both every single day. Yep.
Just, you know, be aware. Less heat is... Always go from the idea of as little heat as possible on your beard.
Absolutely. But I do believe...
To get the style you need.
I do believe some heat is needed for the best feeling beard possible. Oh, 100%. Merritt, with a beard length of yours, what comb do you use?
I used to use the like a bag style brush. That's what I most use. Comb, I have pet comb in the shower to put the make sure the wash gets evenly dispersed and the conditioner gets evenly dispersed. Chicago comb number 10 in the car because it just looks nice. Pop, you know, that's about it.
There you go. What can cause knots in your beard? Omar, I do have a video. If you just look up Dan C. Bearded Knots, it'll give you that. Number one cause is dehydration. Number two cause is over-grooming. Almost always, it's from dehydration and then combing too fast, combing too aggressively. And it can also happen from like tossing and turning in your sleep. Dan, do you comb from the bottom or top of your beard first? Yes. No, I comb in every direction. I do actually have a video on this, Nicholas. I start from the top and comb down. Many people would disagree with me and say with a longer beard, you should start from the bottom and then work your way up to the top. Cool. I like to start at the skin and work my way slowly and gently down the beard. That's what I do. So hopefully that helps. I get one day off per week. On that day, I do nothing with my beard unless I have to leave the house. There you go. I can't do that. My brain literally cannot handle that. I use heat even if I'm not going anywhere. Yeah, I don't like the way I feel
Yeah.
I really don't. I don't like the way I feel.
We yeah. It's just it's easier just to be game ready all the time, really.
Yeah. Jason says, I'm only commenting so I can show off my new picture. Love it, man. Love it. All right. Welcome, Bearded Gamer. Better late. What did I miss? Everything.
All of it.
Yep. If I use butter at night, do I wash in oil in the morning? Also, do I use oil before butter or balm? All right, Barry, here you go. So let me break it down step by step. If I use butter at night, do I wash and oil in the morning? So wash is going to be relative to your wash routine. If you use butter with wax, I do recommend washing. If you don't, you can either go with a rinse day or a wash day. Oil in the morning, yes. Just make sure your beard is damp at least. Also, do I use oil before butter or balm? If it's after a shower, oil, wait 5 minutes, and then balm or butter. If it's not after a shower, if it's just you've already used oil earlier in the day, then you can get the beard damp and use butter. Hopefully that helps out. Caden, reach out to us. Maybe we'd be happy to tell you specifics on scents. Mayor, do we have Instagram?
At Mayor's Beard Journey on Instagram and at Dancy Bearded on Instagram. Yes, we do. We'd love to have you. Check out our accounts.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Do you agree the pain of pulling a beard is the worst? It's up there.
It's awful.
Yeah, it's up there. All right, guys, last question. Then we're going to move on with the other segments here. We know environments and lifestyle often affect what a beard needs and needs to be washed. Facts. But even if you work in an office and live a sedentary lifestyle, how often do you at least need to wash your beard? Sterling, I recommend for everybody at least every other day. Not saying I'm correct. Yeah. I'm not saying that that's right. I'm not saying that that's a rule. Thank you, Doug, by the way. But now, with my experience and what I've learned and what I've gone through, even if I didn't leave air conditioning, I could not imagine going 2 days without washing my beard.
Sounds about right. It doesn't feel right.
Yeah, I just couldn't do that. So that would be my recommendation. Yep. But now I'm at the point where I do wash my beard every single day. Yeah, pretty much every single day. If anything, like Devin's saying there, maybe six times a week. All right.
This is Dave B. Below is the post I put up in Command's Corner Facebook group. The guys suggested I send you a email with pictures for help with trimming. I updated the pictures and took new ones today after washing oil then heat. No butter, balm, or wax. I've finally reached yeard status. Now, however, I'm in desperate need of a trim. I've already trimmed my mustache. I was sick of eating it, but I still need to trim the rest. I've never done this before, and I'm a bit hesitant to do it myself. I can find plenty of barbers around me, but none who advertise that they are beard barbers.
Oh.
Just that they'll do a trim and line up, or without a haircut for around $50. I'm the only one in my friend group with facial hair, so I have no one to ask for recommendation. Any help or advice is greatly appreciated.
All right. And Dave is in here. Thank you, Dave. Okay. We're going to get to the pictures in a second here. But he says, I can find plenty of barbers around me, but none who advertise that they're beard barbers. They'll do a trim and line up or without a haircut for around $50. Dave, I would expand your circle of travel. I would reach a... I have had a lot of guys that are like, I'll recommend a barber to them. This is not Dave, by the way. I'll have guys, I'll recommend a barber and they'll say, man, that's 30 minutes away. I'm like, yeah, you should go 30 minutes. You should go an hour. You should go as far as you need to find a beard barber that you trust and that can do a good job. So Dave, I don't know how far your search range is, and some places are tougher than others. I had someone reach out from South Dakota. There's truly not, guys, there is, at least last time I checked, there are zero barber schools in South Dakota. They have a beautician school, but zero barber schools. Now, that may have changed, but at least when I looked as an active one, there were none available. Literally, no schools. So I would expand your reach, expand your list. You got guys like Mark saying, I go an hour. Brian says, I go 45 minutes. Really try to broaden it. Look for young barbers, too. Nothing against older barbers, but young barbers have come up in an age where beards are a thing. Where beards are styled, where beards are trimmed. Really try to just broaden and go about that. And see, yeah, my guy's about an hour, right? So we got people. The Beard Barber Map list, closest barber to me, an hour. Dave, go. That is your guy. That was submitted by somebody in our beard group
that knows it,
that have been there, that have experienced it. drive that hour. That is the best advice I can give you on that. Okay, now let's take a look. He's said, I'm in desperate need of a trim. Already trimmed my mustache. I'm sick of eating it. What do you guys think here, essentially, given just advice for this? That's a good rule. 1 hour of driving per year of growing. That's definitely a good rule, man. That is a good rule. CBD, Austin, Texas, I'm actually going to be getting a head haircut at the Beard Brand facility. They're barbers. We're going to do a video on their channel, and we're going to do a live stream from the Beard Brand headquarters. So stay tuned. Last week of March. Going to be pretty cool. All right. Ooh, awesome beard, man. I do remember you submitting this on the Facebook group. So awesome. So he said he trimmed his mustache already, but wants some advice on the overall beard. And this is a good one, Dave, because I can see this going in several ways. The first thing that I'm going to recommend is going to be lining up the sideburn. The more and more I think about this, the more and more I look at examples.
More often you want to line up.
I really think this is a no-brainer with transitioning from bald to bearded. You got this nice flat line here, but it's like it's a handle. All I want you to do is cut this angle off just a little bit. See this little portion right here? Just line that angle right there, boom, down to the corner of the mouth, and make that little tiny trim. I think that's going to do a really nice job. You're only just taking off this part. That angle is going to suit you very well. Now, the trim on the body of the beard. This is where I see a few, and absolutely, as everyone's saying in the stream, beautiful beard, man. Beautiful, beautiful beard. And Flag, this is actually where we met. Before I had a YouTube channel, I would comment on Beard Brand live streams. They don't do them anymore. And me and Flag would be, it wasn't very big. Our streams are bigger than what they used to have. Me and Flag would talk in those streams, which is pretty cool. So do you have any thoughts? You want me to kick it on what he should be going for right now with a trim for the shape of this beard?
You know, I do see maybe a little bit of transparency. Possibly just light touch-ups around the edge, maybe under the neck. But I kind of see it on one side, I don't see it on the other, but I think if you take Dan's first advice and kind of look at how that sets everything else up, it'll give you a good idea. Like, you know, going from that fade transition into your head hair, lines things up. I think you'll find maybe that you do want to not shorten the beard, but like I said, we always talk about a transparency just to find that body and bring that out more.
Dave, what is your goal? Yeah. Hit me with that as quickly as you can. That's going to depend on my advice here. What is your beard goal? Are you going big? Do you want a really long beard eventually? Or do you just want the best looking beard possible? Let me know your goal, and then I'm going to give you some very specific advice. And here's a good question from Bearded Gamer. Shirt color. I am a massive, massive believer in shirt color. You will see my beard only with a range of dark, neutral, natural colors because of my beard. This color, I think, is perfect for his beard. He has gray, he's got black in there, he's got a nice heather gray shirt. Perfect. The shirt color does not cause transparency. If this was a yellow shirt underneath this or a white shirt, it would look way more transparent. Way, way more transparent. Okay, I'd love to get a long beard, but overall, I just want the best beard for me. Okay, Dave, I'm going to go a little drastic here, and I think this is going to be the best for what you're going for eventually. I want you to come in and get this one at an angular kind of rounded cut. I want you to go right along almost your collar line of your shirt. I want it down here. Let this portion right here, because see how your beard flares out in the middle? This is the longest part. This is the longest part. There's a V in the middle, that little French fork. I want this to be your baseline, Dave. Right here, and then let's angle off of that. Okay, kind of mimic the flow of your beard, of almost your jawline. This is where you start. If you're going to tell a barber, tell them this is where they want to start. If you want me to draw this, send me a message with the picture, and I will draw it and send it back to you with my thoughts. You don't have to take them, of course. But I'm going to go here and then angle off of that. I know that's probably more than you were expecting or more that you wanted to hear, but I do believe that that's going to set your beard up for the most success. Why? All of these guys are transparent and wispy down here. That just happens with growth, man. That's my beard does it in the growth journey. Anybody's beard does it. I would go for this and transparent. And the reason why I'm giving this advice is because it's bothering you. You put in here, you in this message, because I know people are yelling at me right now and guys are like, don't touch it. Grow it out. That's the best way to solve it. Here's his words, okay, in this one. I'm in desperate need of a trim. I was sick of eating it, but he said, I need to trim the rest, right? So he's talking about this and saying that he needs it. That would be my advice right here, and then go angle off of that. Let us know what you think, Dave. If you come back, please give us some updates. Do you anything with a side profile picture? Do you anything with a side profile picture where the beard goes back towards the ear? Oh, okay, great question, Justin. So when the beard goes back towards the ear, I actually have a video dropping on Sunday that's exactly about this. You are either going to style this into the beard, or if you can't achieve that, then you're going to do a little trim right here. And I will say, Justin, stay tuned for my video on Sunday. All right, he says, it does bother me. I haven't been feeling it lately. I love it. I loved it growing at first. Done. Deal. Dave, do this trim. Sometimes what you need to, like, re-energize your passion of a beard is changing it up. Sometimes you just have to switch it up to know what you miss, what you had, but also to have just a new perspective. Let's go with an angle right here, Dave, and then angle off of this. Trust me. Trust me. You will feel like $1 million. I got you, man. And if you find a good barber, go with that one on the thing and find a good gold beard and get a great barber. Yep. Great advice, Mitch. Great advice. Reach out anytime if you need anything, Dave.
This is Jesse. I'm having issues with hairs falling out. Is there anything I can do that would help? Also need advice on what beard style would work for me. Should I let it grow or keep a business type beard?
Perfect. Let's take a look at the beard and then we'll come back and address the two types of questions you have here. Awesome, Jesse. Hey, man. Super early on in the journey, but great coverage, great beard here. Your first question said, I'm having issues with hairs falling out. Is there anything that I can do? Jesse, every single hair on your body falls out. Every hair has a life cycle that it goes through. I actually have, if you look up Dancy Bearded Beard Hair Life Cycles or Hair Life Cycles, I break down the different cycles, and it's not the most entertaining or electric video, but if you're like a beard nerd, you'll enjoy it. That's called shedding. Jesse, if the hair has a white bulb at the end, it is healthy, 100% normal. If it has a dark bulb at the end, it means it was premature and came out a little bit too early. That's usually from over-grooming or doing something a little bit too aggressive. If there is no bulb at the end, that's breakage and that's a real problem. That means your hairs are breaking off and something is causing that. Whether it's internal health or something externally happening, I have a feeling from your write-up here and from having a newer, shorter beard, you're just going through shedding, man. It's normal. On average, you can lose up to like 35 beard hairs a day and be totally fine, totally normal. Outside of that, he wants to know, is there any advice on what style beard? Should I keep it shorter? Should I grow it? What are your thoughts with his face shape, with his coverage, Mayor?
I think it's too early to tell, but you're going to, I like the short beard style. As you continue to let it grow out, you're going to get a better feel for how it lays and how it changes your face. And then you'll be able to have more info.
Yeah. Yeah. You can do whatever the heck you want, man.
Yep.
This is an open canvas for you. You've got all the cards to go wherever you want. The best advice I would give for you is find some, as Mitch said last time, find some beards that you really like and start working towards those goals. If you want to send back in a couple of weeks with a goal picture, we can tell you things to get to that goal. So yeah, it's literally whatever you want. There's nothing about your face shape, nothing about your coverage genetics that would say, hey, you're limited to this one. You could go wherever you want, man, wherever you want. If you're not sure, don't touch it. Yep, do not touch it on that one. I've heard of people talking about sea salt. Can anybody tell me about it? Stay away from sea salt. Domingo, if you look up Dancy Bearded sea salt spray, I have a video. Essentially, salt is a dehydrator. It's going to suck all the moisture out of your beard. You don't want that. Head hair, totally fine. Beard, not so much.
This is Felipe. I have been grasped by big beard envy.
Yeah.
My last trim date was back in last September. I've not touched the beard since then. I am 5 inches. I think of letting the beard go natural for the coming month. Beard, mustache, cheek line. What would you suggest for me to do during this process?
Okay. So he's saying, I'm going to let the beard go for a month, not touch it. What do you suggest? Let's take a look, and then we'll give him some advice here. Hey, Felipe, awesome, man. I was thinking much shorter
yeah.
on this time. All right, so he's saying, I'm not going to touch it for a month. I'm going to let that go. And that's good, man. And to be real, that's a short time frame in the beard world, right? A month right. That's not a ton of time. I think you'll be totally fine without touching that. But I think that's more around your territory. Mm-hmm. Do you normally trim within a month?
Yeah, you know, I have a few areas, the corners of my mouth, corners of my neckline. They just kind of seem to bother me sooner on, so they're kind of flags. So I have like little things that I do, and then I have like a bigger trim, like the video I made a few weeks ago, a month ago. However long ago it was.
And you have a similar size beard as Felipe here. You also have gone through times where you were like, let's say I put out a challenge or somebody else, and you were like, I'm not trimming for a month. With that, what you've learned in your experiences, any advice you'd give to Felipe during this month of him, it seems like for the first time saying, I'm not going to touch it.
You know, honestly, a month, my advice is go for 2 months.
Ooh.
Because a month, I think is right in that realm of just kind of being in that. You know, my beard style is a range of length, and you probably, if you have worn that for a while, have settled into a range that you're comfortable with your beard on your face. So you're still going to, you know, how much farther out of your range in a month are you going to be? Probably not much of it.
True.
So push yourself a little bit and kind of, you know, push beyond those little areas that bother you and see what happens.
Love that. I did not expect that. That was beyond my expectations in a great way. Love that. He said, why a month? Do two. Now, here's something that hit me when you said that. You said that your beard is of a range. So interesting, because it is. Like, thinking back, I'm like, oh, yeah, you've had your beard significantly longer.
Right.
That doesn't come to mind when I see you. Like, when I see you, when you come over, I don't think, oh, Mayor's on his short beard phase right now. That's wild. But when I think about it, I'm like, oh, yeah, he's had the shelf of his beard significantly longer.
Right.
But that's never struck me in the mind. Interesting.
And yet, you know, we're so hard on ourselves sometimes.
Right.
Yeah, you're the beard guy. You see me every week.
Right.
You see my face every day.
Dude, that was kind of a light bulb moment, is we're so hard on ourselves. Mm-hmm. That difference to you is probably massive. Right?
Sure.
Massive.
Oh, yeah. I can see it in photos. And sometimes I have to look back and say, when was that? You know, like.
But it literally has not come across my mind to say, oh, yeah, you're at a short phase, right? Interesting.
Especially after.
Keep that in mind, guys.
Because I think you used to watch to see, like, is he really settling into having a beard? And you would pay attention to that, right? We would talk about it. But once you know that I'm in and it's good, it's like you just kind of, it's such a small little fluctuation.
Interesting. And it probably has to do with me seeing you so frequently, too.
Probably.
That the changes are more gradual. If I didn't see you for a month and it was a month longer, maybe I would notice more. Interesting. Good food for thought that you sparked there, Felipe. But I agree with the mayor. I got nothing to add, man. Patience. Go for 2 months. You've got a great beard. Your style's immaculate, dude. The head hair, goodness gracious, is that some great head hair. The glasses, look good, man. Very, very stylish.
Caleb C., I've been growing my beard for about 9 months, and overall I'm pretty happy with everything, despite some pretty intense waves. But there's one thing that has me close to just giving up and shaving and everything off.
Woo!
Under my beard, my neckline grows straight forward, followed by an S-shaped wave. So from a certain angle, my beard almost appears to be hollow from underneath, even though it looks like I have even growth. I've used various heat methods, but nothing has worked so far. The only thing that I'd add is that my only goal was to grow it as long as possible with no trimming.
Okay, good to know on the adding on the goal there. And he's saying, okay, I'm 9 months in, my underbeard neckline grows straight forward in S shape, so at a certain angle, it appears that it's hollow from underneath. So transparent, something like that. And while we're getting here and we're reading this, Mayor, will you hit up Domingo? He says, how can I send in a pic for my beard evaluation? Sorry, new here.
Beardadvicelive@gmail.com is the email. Send, like you said, front-facing pic, side pic, and your description of what you're asking us for.
Yep, Domingo, watch the show, see how these entries go. And if you forget, the email's scrolling down at the bottom. It's pinned in the chat, and it's in the description of every Beard Advice Live video. Awesome. And guys, remember, if you want to go back and watch older lives, YouTube has a set tab for lives now. It's no longer on the video feed. It's under the live feed, just like they have a short feed. Okay. Let's take a look at Caleb's. It's Caleb.
Yeah.
Goodness gracious.
Okay. He's ready to shave it off. Did he say that in his...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dear.
Caleb, prepare for these comments.
We got some problems.
He said, but giving up, there's one thing... Okay, so this is what he's saying. I think he's saying this portion right here is where he is having problems, because he said at a certain angle, it can look like the beard is hollow, meaning like here's how I'll break it down. When you look at the side of my beard here, it's just a solid mass. And Caleb is saying, if you look at my beard from a certain angle, it looks like there's a portion missing and it's not solid. I can respect that. I can acknowledge that. We're not going to diminish that because you have a great beard. You see that. You experience that. I get that. I'm here to tell you that doesn't matter.
And it doesn't hit anyone like that. But
nobody in the entire world, from beard champions to beard content creators to beard envyists. I think that's a real thing, an envyist.
Sure.
So, dude, this is an amazing beard, a natural beard. If you wanted to combat that, we could do it with heat. We could do it with a round brush and a blow dryer. But I don't want that for your beard.
No.
My beard is very... I'm going to cut the mirror out here slightly. My beard is very straight. It's just kind of how I like it, how I go with it. Your beard is not, and I don't think it should be,
no,
dude.
No, it just like...
Your beard,
yeah,
is fantastic. And Caleb, I hope that you read these comments. I hope that you read these comments, man. Again, I get what you're saying here. I see how your neckline grows straight out, so it's almost like your beard is protruding from your face. If it caused transparency and it caused it to be see-through, I would say, okay, let's adjust. Let's do something here. No. And I get the underbeard here. I see all that. This is iconic. This is unique. This is amazing. Your mustache, the whole thing is just legendary, dude. Absolutely legendary. I agree with Flag here. It has its own character. In a great way. In an absolute great way. Look at Roger said, my son just walked by and I had to stop him to say, look at this epic beard. Dude, I hope that you hear this. I hope that you read this. And I hope that you feel this. Please don't touch this beard. You should be proud of this. Mm-hmm. You should be braggadocious. You should show this off. You should walk into a room and say, I know what everybody's looking at. I know the first thought on everybody's mind. And it's your beard, right? Wow. Don't trim. You said a goal of yours is to grow it out as long as possible with no trimming. I wouldn't even know where to tell you to trim, dude. It is wonderful.
There's people that will try to style their beard like your curls are.
Uh-huh.
Like, people chase that look.
Yep.
So, yeah, you're not... Sorry, dude.
Yeah, I think... I don't know if you're in the chat, Caleb, or if you watch in the future, but, dude, keep it up, man. It looks amazing. Absolutely amazing. Wow. Yeah, absolutely.
A lot of people chase that look.
Yep.
All right, this is Matthew M. Hey, guys and community, just wanted to send you a quick update picture after a week of training and applying yours and the community's tips and suggestions. Of course, the advice is welcome. I just don't have any specific questions. Finally, thank you for everybody again.
Awesome. Caleb's on, it looks like, I'm guessing, the wife's account, Rachel, and he says, thank you all. John, are you related to Caleb? That would be crazy. Dude, I hope your wife heard this. I hope everybody heard this. This is, wow, an amazing beard. Matthew, let's see your update, my man. I think this might be the last one, guys. Here we go. So this was last week. Again, guys, we said great beard, but yes. Essentially he was saying, hey, I've got these S curves. I got these little unbalance here, and he started training it. Look at the difference here. It's small, but purposeful. Mm-hmm. Love it, dude. Keep going with it. Keep trying. Keep styling and adjusting. I think that you're in that mid-step, and I think that you're going to continue in a few weeks to dial it into the perfection that you want it to be. It looks really nice. I love the growth and everything that you're doing right here. Anything that you would add, Mayor?
Not really. Just nice job. Just continue. Like, it'll grow out. Go less is more as far as trimming adjustments. Don't go crazy with it.
Awesome, dude. Awesome. And let me check here. Like I said, I think it's the last one. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And then look at this. Caleb said, wife also here, just here to say, I told him so. And also, for the record, I've forbidden the shaving. You are a keeper.
Yes.
Absolutely amazing. You don't understand,
she
Rachel.
She sees the value.
Mm-hmm. You don't understand how many guys have to battle their significant other because they don't want the beard. They don't want this. And Rachel, kudos to you, because I got to put this back up here. Where the breaking point is for most women, is the mustache and the kissing. And so for you saying those things, wow. Like, I feel like you and Sam would be friends. You seem like a very cool person from just two sentences. So that is really cool. Hey, guys, what a freaking show. Oh, my gosh, this was awesome. Please continue to get involved. Continue to help your beard, the community, this channel. Send in beardadvicelive@gmail.com. We love this. We need this. You guys are helping so many people that you will never see, you will never hear from, but thousands of people watch this show and they take bits and pieces away and they apply it to themselves. It helps their journey. It helps their confidence. It really is more impactful than you would likely ever realize. And thank you guys for everything that you do, from giving your advice in the chat, from giving support and just simply saying, hey, great beard. Think about how many people have written something negative about their beard and then walked away with their chest a little bit higher, with that smile a little bit bigger. That's because of you guys. And I do mean that. So thank you so much. Mayor, sorry there. Take it away. What you got?
Hey, guys, I want you to have a wonderful rest of the week. I'll see you Sunday on Beyond Bearded here on the channel. I love that we do this. Thanks for being here. Thanks for support. So many surprises tonight. This is what the show's all about. We'll see you next week.
And if you guys sent in pictures, we will get you on the next week. Look out for an email in a couple of days from us letting you know that you'll be on. And we'll get everything set up for next week. BeardAdviceLive@gmail.com. Reach out to us anytime. And as I said at the start of the show, 8 p.m. Eastern on Sunday, Beyond Bearded, interviewing a financial expert, a college baseball, former college baseball star. It's going to be a great show, you guys. That's the mayor in his studio, killing it. Appreciate you guys. And we are out of here. Please stay bearded, stay positive, and go enjoy the heck out of the rest of your week. Later, you guys.